गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन टूडेज क्लास वी विल स्टार्ट विद द पोएम चीवी कंपोज बाय एन इंग्लिश चिल्ड्रंस नॉवलिस्ट पोएट एंड द ऑथर माइकल रोजेन हु वॉज बॉर्न ऑन 7 May 1946 इन हारो लार्ज टाउन इन ग्रेटर लंडन इंग्लैंड यूके. ही सर्व्ड एज चिल्ड्रंस लॉरिएट फ्रॉम जून 2007 टू जून 2009. दिस पोएम इज बेस्ड ऑन द रियल इंसिडेंट ऑफ द पोएट्स लाइफ. This poem deals with the feelings of the poet as well as the feelings of other small kids who feel irritated as their elders or grown-ups always instruct them to do and not to do. In other words, the dominating behavior of the grown-ups or the elders makes the young kids or small kids feel irritated. Okay, so for detailed explanation and analysis of the poem, let's go through the poem and enjoy. All right, now first of all, let's talk about the central idea of the poem. In this poem, the poet says that our elders or grown-ups always remind or urge us constantly to do something in every way possible. They want to teach us good manners. They tell us to speak up, not to talk while eating something, not to look fixedly at anybody, not to point, not to pick or clean the nose, or you can say not to extract or remove mucus from your nose with our fingers. Most children don't like such nagging or interruptions and they feel irritated. Grown-ups or the elders also teach young ones to say please, to stay quiet, to shut the door behind them, keep a hanky, not to drag feet while walking, and take their hands out of their pockets. In the concluding lines of the poem, the poet says that grown-ups or elders shout at their kids to pull their socks up, to stand straight or upright, to say thank you when somebody gives them something or when they receive any gift or when any service is done to them. Children are also instructed not to interrupt or speak in between, take their elbows off the table, or they should not rest their elbows on the table. Thus, grown-ups or adults or elders try to teach their young ones good manners and norms of a cultured and sophisticated life. Grown-ups also expect the children to make their own mind up about anything. Means they also expect the children to think freely or independently and behave nicely. Here the poet takes a satirical tone at the end of the poem and talks about the importance of freedom, self-dependence, and interrogates about the need of being instructed by the grown-ups. इस पोएम के माध्यम से पोएट ये बताना चाहता है कि बड़ी आयु के लोग यानी ग्रोनअप्स और एडल्ट पीपल आमतौर से अपने बच्चों को शिष्टाचार सिखाने हेतु हर बात पर टोकते हैं, उन्हें मना करते रहते हैं, ये मत करो, वो मत करो. वे बच्चों से कहते हैं, बोलो, गूंगे बनकर मत बैठो, खाना खाते समय बातें मत करो, किसी की ओर घूर कर मत देखो, किसी की ओर उंगली से संकेत करके बात मत करो, तथा अपनी नाक अपनी फिंगर से उंगली से साफ मत करो. अधिकांश बच्चों को यह बात अच्छी नहीं लगती. एडल्ट पीपल और ग्रोनअप्स वयस्क लोग अपने छोटे बच्चों को सिखाते रहते हैं कि कृपया शब्द बोलो, चुप रहो, कमरे में प्रवेश करने के पश्चात दरवाज़ा बंद कर दो, रुमाल अपने पास रखो, पैरों को घसीटते हुए मत चलो तथा जेब से हाथ बाहर निकाल लो. वे बच्चों को डांट कर बताते हैं कि अपने सॉक्स ऊपर खींच लो, सीधे खड़े होना सीखो, धन्यवाद देना मत भूलो, दूसरों की बातचीत में दखल मत दो तथा मेज पर टेबल पर अपने एल्बोस को कोहनी को टिकाकर मत बैठो। वे बच्चों को शिष्टाचार तथा अच्छी जीवन शैली के नियम सिखाते रहते हैं। वे यह भी अपेक्षा करते हैं कि बच्चे स्वतंत्र रूप से निर्भय तथा शिष्ट आचरण करें। हर माता पिता की यही इच्छा होती है कि उसके बच्चे शिष्ट हों, सदाचारी हों, उनके अंदर हार्ड स्किल्स के साथ साथ सॉफ्ट स्किल्स भी हों। पर क्या हम अपने बच्चों को इस तरह से हर बात पर इंटरप्ट करके उनकी स्वयं की सोच, चिंतन तथा कल्पनाशीलता को अवरुद्ध तो नहीं कर रहे? यह बात भी विचारणीय है। ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी द पोयम। द टाइटल ऑफ द पोयम इज चीवी एंड द नेम ऑफ द पोएट हु हैज कंपोज्ड दिस पोयम इज माइकल रोजिन। हियर चीवी मीन्स एनवाय कंटिन्यूली और क्रॉनिकली। द डिक्शनरी मीनिंग ऑफ चीवी इज टू कंटिन्यूअसली अर्ज समवन टू डू समथिंग ऑफन इन एन अनवाइंग वे। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर वी गो थ्रू द एक्सप्लेनेशन पोएटिक डिवाइसेस एंड वोकैबुलरी एनहेंसमेंट, आई वुड लाइक टू पुट अप सम क्वेश्चंस। सो आर यू रेडी? ऑलराइट, सो माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, डू यू लाइक टू बी ऑलवेज टोल्ड व्हाट टू डू और व्हाट नॉट टू डू? एंड माय सेकंड क्वेश्चन इज, डू ग्रोनअप्स डू दिस इन योर एक्सपीरियंस? स्टूडेंट्स, जस्ट थिंक ओवर इट एंड गिव आंसर इन द लाइव चैट कॉलम। ओनली आंसर इन एस और नो। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट दिस पोएम इज बेस्ड ऑन द रियल इंसिडेंट ऑफ पोएट्स लाइफ। व्हेन द पोएट वॉज 5 years ओल्ड, हिज मदर टूक हिम टू अ नियर बाय स्कूल फॉर एडमिशन। द टीचर आस्क्ड, व्हाट डज योर मदर कॉल यू एट होम चाइल्ड? Michael don't, came the confident reply. When the teacher asked the poet what his name was or what his mother called him at home, the poet replied confidently and told his teacher that his name was Michael don't. Now let's read and enjoy the poem. Grown-ups say things like, speak up, don't talk with your mouth full, don't stare, don't point, don't pick your nose. In these lines, the poet says that grown-ups or adult people usually have the habit of asking the children to speak up. Here, speak up means to speak louder, ऊंचे स्वर में बोलना. Another meaning, adult people ask their kids to speak up or answer the questions in audible voice. Don't talk with your mouth full means adult people also instruct their young ones not to talk while eating something. Here, with your mouth full means while eating something. Elder people remind their children not to talk in the middle of a meal. Grown-ups always teach good manners saying, don't stare means not to look at someone constantly. Here, stare means to look fixedly. Don't point means not to point someone with your fingers while talking to someone. Here, point means indicate towards anything. Don't pick your nose. Here, pick your nose means to clean your nose with your finger or to extract or remove mucus from your nose. Grown-ups also ask their kids not to pick or clean their nose with their fingers. Now let's talk about poetic devices. First, let's see the rhyme scheme. Here in this poem, there is no fixed rhyme scheme. So your answer will be no fixed rhyme scheme. In the lines, don't talk with your mouth full, don't stare, don't point, and don't pick your nose, here the poet has stressed the word don't. When there is the repetition of word or phrase at the beginning of successive clauses, it is called anaphora. एक के बाद आने वाले क्रमिक उपवाक्यों में शब्द या वाक्यांश की पुनरावृत्ति को अनेफ्रा कहा जाता है. ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी नेक्स्ट स्टैंजा. सिट अप, से प्लीज, लेस नॉइज, शट द डोर बिहाइंड यू, डोंट ड्रैग योर फीट, हैवेंट यू गॉट अ हैंकी, टेक योर हैंड्स आउट ऑफ योर पॉकेट्स. हियर इन दीज लाइन्स द पोएट सेज दैट grown-ups instruct their kids to sit up means to sit straight or in a correct posture or to make their back straight. Grown-ups also teach the young children to say please, to keep quiet, to make less noise means not to talk so loudly. They also instruct their kids to shut the door behind them, keep a hanky means here handkerchief, hanky means handkerchief, don't drag your feet means not to drag means trail, T-R-A-I-L, trail on the ground their feet while walking. Grown-ups usually ask their kids to take their hands out of their pockets. So these are the certain good manners which are taught by grown-ups to their young children so that they may lead their life in a sophisticated and cultured manner. Alright, now let's talk about the poetic devices used in this stanza. You see the line, don't drag your feet, and the line, take your hands out of. Here, the poetic device that has been used is alliteration. In Hindi, we call it anupras. It's a poetic device in which the same letter or sound occur at the beginning of adjacent or closely connected words. In the line, don't drag your feet, the same letter D is repeated and they are adjacent or closely connected words. In the line, take your hands out of, here the poet again uses alliteration. As both words out and off start with the same sound O. I think it would have been clear to you. Okay, now let's read the next stanza. Pull your socks up, stand up straight, say thank you, don't interrupt. No one thinks you are funny, take your elbows off the table. In these lines, the poet says that grown-ups always guide their children to live and behave nicely. They instruct their kids to pull their socks up. Here, socks, you know, short stocking, S-H-O-R-T, short stocking, S-T-O-C-K-I-N-G. They ask their children to stand up straight. Here, straight means upright, U-P-R-I-G-H-T, upright. Say thank you, don't interrupt, means grown-ups expect from their children that when somebody gives them something, they should say thank you, and also they should not interrupt, means speak in between. Interrupt means speak in between. The poet here means to say that when two or more people are talking each other or one another, children are not expected to cut in or speak in between as it is not a good manner. No one thinks you are funny. It means when children try to do something funny to attract others' attention, or when the child has done some mischief and is finding it funny and hence annoying anybody else, or when a child cracks a joke or laughs, then the parents say, no one thinks you are funny. अर्थात कोई भी ऐसा नहीं सोचता कि तुम्हारी बात हास्यप्रद है, यानी funny है. Here funny means interesting, I-N-T-E-R-E-S-T-I-N-G, interesting, or another meaning humorous, H-U-M-O-R-O-U-S, humorous. Children are also instructed not to rest their elbows on the table. Take your elbows off the table. Here, off means away, A-W-A-Y. So, children are also instructed not to rest their elbows on the table. Can't you make your own mind up about anything? It's a couplet. Couplet, you know, C-O-U-P-L-E-T. In Hindi, we call it Doha. So, these are the concluding lines of the poem in which the adult is asking the child to learn manners and take decisions like grown-ups. They want the child to think and act on his own. Here, make up your mind means take a decision, means nirnay lena. But what happens? Grown-ups don't allow their children to take any decision. They always tell them what to do or what not to do. And they are asking their children to make up his own mind. So the poet finds it unreasonable. Thus, grown-ups say such kind of things mentioned in the poem to their children so that they may teach them good manners, etiquettes, and how to behave in public. And it is important to teach the children all these things so that they may learn good manners and how to behave in the society, at home, and with their elders and youngsters. Okay, now let's see the poetic devices used in this stanza. You see the line, stand up straight. Here the letters S are repeated at the beginning of words stand and straight. So your poetic device will be alliteration. And in the line, take your elbows off the table, there is the repetition of letter T in the words take, the, and table. So the poetic device will be alliteration. In the line, can't you make your own, the same letter Y is repeated in the words you and your. So here poetic device will be alliteration. The use of same letter or sound at the beginning of words that are close together is called alliteration. किसी शब्द समूह में एक ही अक्षर या ध्वनि से आरंभ होने वाले शब्दों का प्रयोग अनुप्रास अलंकार कहलाता है. In the line, mind up about anything, there is also the repetition of letter A in about and anything. So, it will also be alliteration. Students, that's all for today's class. For question answer and other support material, you may log on to my blog http://englishguru121.blogspot.com. And if you want to keep in touch with this channel, please don't forget to subscribe and also press the bell notification icon so that you may get latest updates regarding your syllabus, question paper, exam dates, and many more. Thanks for being with this channel. Have a great day.